So if you didn't know, every year they have the CTT AGM where they basically talk and decide all the rules for time trials, and this year it's disaster. So in the past, basically they haven't really done very much controversial stuff. The most controversial thing they did was about 2 years ago where they made rear lights compulsory, which was like, in my opinion, pointless. Okay, time trials I understand, but it also applies to hill climbs, and like in a closed road hill climb, you have to have a like rear light, and it's like, what is the point of that? No car's gonna run you over. For my mate, he's selling these things called brick caps. They're really cool. They're like Lego heads that you screw in onto your Presta valves. They look sick. I'll give a little link below. They're really cool. Definitely check them out. Ideal for a Christmas present for someone if they like riding a bike. But anyway, now we're gonna, but you know, it's a small thing, but they could have changed it. Anyway, today, disaster struck. They've made helmets compulsory. And you might say, okay, like, why is that a disaster? Well, for time trials, the rule is irrelevant because, let's be honest, about 99.9% of people are going to wear a helmet in a time trial. So it doesn't actually change anything on a time trial. The thing it changes is a hill climb. And you might say, Charlie, well, you actually have had brain surgery. Why are you so anti-helmets in hill climbs? And I think there's many reasons. I think, number one, you should always be able to have free choice. And I think it's quite unique that in a cycling competition that you can still not wear helmets. And that's because the insurance CTT has allows you to do it, which I think is really nice. Now, I think the other thing is that you should have choice. You should be able to decide what you want. And I think like that's obviously more than just CTT. That's generally what I think in most of life. But I think in time trials and hill climbs, it's like, time trials, as I said, is irrelevant. But for hill climbs, I think what's really unique about them is actually the photo and the whole thing is that you actually get to see the person. You don't just see them with the helmet and glasses on and like, you know, you actually get to see the pain phases, you see everything else, and they don't look like a robot. Like if you watch the Tour de France, they all go up, they all look like robots. Like all you can see is just, you know, helmets and glasses. So I think that's really unique, and also the photos are really special. And then of course, like weight and all the rest of it is why most people don't wear them. However, you know, you're gonna already get back at me and say, "Oh, Tom Bell won nationals with a helmet." Yeah, he did, but Tom Bell would have won nationals, you know, with some other things. I mean, like, you know, he could. Could have probably worn like literally a chicken suit or something stupid, like, you know, a fancy dress suit, and probably still could have won it. I mean, it's like, so I don't think that's necessarily an argument against or for it, but I just think you should be able to have choice, and I think it's quite lame that people have voted for this. And I guess the other argument people say is, why don't you get involved in CTT? Well, I guess that is a good point. I probably should if I have such strong opinions, but I just think it's a bit lame. I don't know who votes it through. I feel like, you know, maybe instead of having an AGM where you have to delegate people because, like, you know, the club delegates to the district and the district goes to the AGM, they just had a vote on it. Like every CTT member can just have a vote. I feel like that would be better. But anyway, that's not really here nor there. And the other rule, which is even more stupid than a helmet rule, because a helmet rule, like, oh, fair enough, safety. A front light? I'm sorry, but why do you need a front light? It makes absolutely zero sense. Like, no one does time trials in the dark. Like a rear light, you're like, oh, maybe, you know, if you're quite aero, it can be hard to see. But like, come on, you know, why do you need a front light? I know you're gonna say, oh, people pull out in front of them. It's like, mate, if they're not gonna see you on a time trial bike in the middle of the day, a front light ain't gonna help. It's just stupid. And then also, it's not like it's hill climb, like hill climbs are excluded. Hill climbs are also kept in as well. So now you have a front light and a rear light. And like, I hate stupid rules. And you know I hate stupid rules because I have a red light. A rear light, which is a stupid red LED connected to a battery which no one can see, and that's just because it weighs like 4 grams. And it's also just to say, like, it's a stupid rule, we don't need it. Like, why is there so much regulation in time trials? Absolute joke. And then the front light, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Obviously, for like hill climbs, I'll get some stupid LED again. For TTs, I'm not sure exactly what I'm gonna do. I mean, I also don't know how visible it has to be. Like, can I just have it like near the front? But like behind the extension, like, I don't know. I'm gonna have a look at the rules and regulations and figure it out. But rest assured, this boy is gonna try and conform as minimally as possible to these stupid rules. And I just don't understand, like, you know, why it's such a weird process to get it both through. There's like an AGM and in each district, as I said before, and it's just like, but like they're things that affect everyone. It's just dumb. And it's like, it makes me just less, like, I'm just like, why? It's so much effort. Like, time trials used to be so chill. You just rock up. You don't even need a rear light. Don't need a helmet. Don't need this. Don't need that. And then, you know, you just do your effort and then cheerio. And it's quite nice. And now it's like, need a helmet. Need rear light. Need a front light. And it's like, boy, it's just chill. We need less regulations and just more chilling. And it'll be a lot better. But anyway, those are just my thoughts. What do you think? Are you for the helmet proposition for time trials and hill climbs in the UK and for the front light? as well, or are you against it? Obviously, let me know your comments below, and hopefully this boy is going to continue whacking out videos into the future and maybe stop being so lazy as I have been in the month of November.